Upstream from the Chesapeake Bay, an important group of animals lives quietly under the surface. Freshwater mussels inhabit wide stretches of the Chesapeake watershed, from tidal rivers to the highest headwaters. Like oysters, they filter water, but they live farther upstream. Because of pollution and other problems, freshwater mussels are the most at-risk group of animals in North America.
About 70% of the species are extinct, rare, threatened, or endangered. These are the five native freshwater mussel species we have been propagating.
In DC and Maryland, Jorge Bogantes leads mussel restoration efforts for the nonprofit Anacostia Watershed Society.
Here we are at the Bladensburg Waterfront Park, one of the places where we culture freshwater mussels before we release them into the river.
Since 2018, AWS has released tens of thousands of hatchery-raised mussels into the Anacostia River to boost imperiled populations and improve the health of the river itself.
It used to be called the Forgotten River. The river was really, really challenged. Different kinds of pollution, including pollution from the combined sewer overflow. It took a lot of effort, and now we're seeing the fruits. A lot of water quality variables have been improving the last decade or so. We've seen wildlife rebounding. Freshwater mussels depend on fish to complete their life cycle. The larval stage must be attached to a fish. That parasitic life stage lasts for about 3 weeks, and then they drop to the riverbed and become filter feeders as we know them. A species like a lamb mussel will use, let's say, a largemouth bass as a host fish. They even have a little mantle lure to attract the fish.
Because mussels depend on fish, any impediment to fish migration is also a barrier for mussels.
We have put dams in rivers blocking migration of fish, so that has been one of the main threats. We have been doing mussel surveys since 2015 in partnership with the Maryland Department of Natural Resources. We do tag some of the mussels. Look for a flat side of the shell. Put a drop of super glue.
Tagging the mussels helps AWS monitor the mussel population of the Anacostia River over time.
We're here at Buzzer Point, at the confluence between the Anacostia River and the Potomac River. This is where we have high-quality mussel beds. All the 8 species of mussels that are known to occur in the Anacostia are here. This is what you want to have, these kind of old mussel beds that provide a lot of ecosystem services. According to our monitoring and our partners' monitoring work at the Anacostia River Keeper, is normally has very low bacteria level to the point that is considered swimmable by EPA standards. Maybe a lot of that is because of the mussels. That's at least what we would like to think.